Great. My name is Ian. I'm joined here with Adetcha. We both kind of work in the data science teams at InMobi. And today we wanted to talk through a process called lookalike modeling and wanted to really get into the detail of exactly what's going on behind the scenes so that you can understand exactly when you actually kind of run these campaigns, how the different kind of sort of pitfalls that you need to kind of be aware of, how best to kind of leverage the technique. So,
cool. Thanks again for the introductions. So, if I'm an advertiser and I'm here to run a campaign and I want only my super users who have basically done more transactions for myself, how would I identify them and run a campaign on it?
Yeah, great. So let's just assume that our starting point, you split your user base into, like as you said, your super users, and then we've kind of got the normal users who aren't necessarily bad, but they kind of make this lower number of transactions. And you really want to identify more super users so that you're going to get a kind of a better return on your investment. And so what you would start to do is that you would basically send over a list of device identifiers for your super user set. And in kind of our context from a lookalike service, we'll actually call this our positive users. Because these are the ones where we want to identify more of those. Now, this is this kind of step here. Now the thing is, at this point, you've just simply put over a list of IDs, and it could mean kind of nothing. So what we actually need to do is we need to be able to understand the characteristics of those users versus other users. Now there's a couple of different ways we can do this from the perspective of what we might call the negative set. Now the negative set, you can actually send us over a list of your normal users who are making these kind of lower number of transactions, and you say, I want ones like our super users, not like our kind of normal users. Now, in order to try and, as I kind of said before, to try and distinguish between these two sets, what we first need to do is kind of build up what we call a feature vector, which is basically the things which we would associate with one of these sets of users versus the other. And so what we do is we have this kind of universe of users at InMobi. So these are all of the different kind of users which we've seen on the network. And we build up these kind of feature vectors. Now that sounds a kind of a complicated way of saying, we know what kind of the device is. We kind of see where the kind of the user's kind of coming from when ad requests are sent, the time of day when they're kind of active, maybe some kind of broad locations in terms of like primary cities and countries and so on. And you can just imagine this, obviously there's just a very kind of high level overview of those. But we need to do this kind of overlap here. And we actually then end up at this point where we have these feature vectors. So we've had this overlap stage and we've kind of got ourselves a kind of a positive set and a negative set of the kind of the users. And that's basically allowing us to have the characteristics. And we'll use those characteristics to try and tease apart the two things, as in what's kind of in common to one particular set of users versus the other. So we've kind of drawn this out here just to kind of illustrate what a feature vector might look like. And we might say that this represents a particular year of manufacture for a device. So if we kind of say this is going to be like, you know, it's predominantly kind of like 2018, and so we might kind of say it's a kind of a more recent device. We might say that they're kind of interested in kind of sports games. Here we might kind of say that they're active predominantly in the evening. Here this might be kind of like a primary sort of city where that user tends to send their requests from. But you can kind of imagine that this kind of goes on and on. And this is effectively the feature vector for that individual user. So that's the characteristics of that user. Now, what we kind of want to do in this kind of model training where we actually kind of use our kind of machine learning techniques is to automatically identify the traits that are common to the positive set, common to the kind of the negative set, and which ones distinguish between the two. So we can kind of split the set. And this allows us to then take an individual user and to take the kind of optimum sort of like configuration from the model training and to calculate the distance between the two. So if we imagine that we were looking for devices that were manufactured in 2018, the user has an interest in kind of sports, they kind of are from particular kind of cities, the distance between that user and our kind of target user would be very small, so it would kind of score highly. Versus if they were kind of like, it was like the devices were manufactured in 2016, they have no interest in sports, and they're kind of like, they're not from the particular cities which the model was scoring, the distance between those two things, when we measure it, would be kind of far away. And so that, in effect, is the kind of the model training process. And as we kind of compare these feature vectors, that's what we kind of call the scoring. And so what the users which we're actually scoring on are what we kind of refer to as the universe of users. So what that means is that we start off with this, all of these users here, and we've taken away the positive set because we don't want to score on the positive set.
Yeah.
We also take away the negative set because again we don't want to kind of score on that. Yeah. But all of those other users who are kind of remaining, who are kind of applicable from your perspective as you, as the advertiser looking for your super users, they're the ones which we would calculate these scores from. And then we would actually take the very, very best kind of matches, and that would kind of, that expanded set is effectively your kind of your audience, your lookalike. And that's the, then what you would take that, and then we would kind of run on that, and you would run your kind of campaign on that. And you would generally expect to kind of see kind of far superior performance than if you just simply had a kind of blindly targeted kind of campaign.
That's fascinating. So as an advertiser, do I have to send a specific number of users to you as my super users and normal users?
Yeah, so if you just sent a very, very kind of low number of users, perhaps like 100, and we kind of did an overlap and we might kind of say match sort of 80 of them, the reality is that that data in terms of the traits which we kind of use to build out the model might be kind of much, much weaker. So it might be that we they're not as statistically significant, and we'd run the risk of actually just having a kind of convergence and outputting a lookalike, which is reflect that small kind of niche point, but actually your larger user base of the super users, it might not be reflective. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of a very good point that you kind of need to consider.
Thanks for the explanation.
Yeah.
It was pretty helpful.
The other thing, just before we kind of close, to keep in mind is that when you're actually running this, what you also kind of might do is you might kind of filter on a particular operating system. You might kind of say, I'm only interested in sort of Android devices. I'm only interested in kind of more premium devices. So you can actually add some extra filters at the start of this process, even before you actually kind of get into kind of running here, just to kind of reduce this universe of users down to something that already is kind of like, it's based upon your kind of domain expertise, and that you know what works well for your kind of your particular user base, but you don't know necessarily the fine-grained details, which only an ML model would be able to kind of pick up. And so overall, this is the kind of workflow as to how a lookalike modeling process sort of works, and it would, you know, we see kind of great performance here. If you have any questions, please do kind of reach out to us, but many thanks for your time and for watching. Bye for now.
Yeah, thank you.